If you are surfing YouTube these days, this face must have come across your eyes. His name is Shri M. He is a great yogi and a spiritual teacher. He is a practitioner of Kriya Yoga, a powerful type of yoga. His guru's name was Maheshwarnath Babaji and Mahavatar Babaji. You may have also seen him giving an interviews on many podcasts. Many books by Shri M are also popular in the market, and from these books he has revealed many secrets of his life. He describes in his book Shri M's The Journey Continue how he had met a Gautam Buddha himself in a previous life and what Gautam Buddha had discussed with him. There are many things beyond the intellectual capacity of common people like us. Because to understand these things, we need to keep aside our limited logic and be open-minded and understand the science behind these things. This is Shri M's past life experience. In one of his previous births, Shri M was born in a community where people used to burn dead bodies after taking them to the crematorium. Shri M's name was Mukha at that birth, which also means dumb. Dumb was the name because he had not spoken since the age of 5. He was then working on the famous Manikarnika Ghat, which is situated on the bank of river Ganga. He had to cremate 100 bodies there every day, and because of this, the people of that time did not allow such men like Mukha to come to the religious places. But from childhood, he had a habit of listening attentively to religious discourses and philosophical debates. Because during that time, such philosophical debates used to take place in ancient cities like Varanasi. Gradually, by the age of 35, he realized that this world had nothing much to offer. As he was working at Manikarnika Ghat, he had seen all the people from a very rich to very poor and the very wise to the dumb getting ashes after their death. So he used to say that there is a lot of joy in this world, but we are also trapped in the circle of Maya. Mukha's wife had passed away. His daughter also died within a year after his wife. Mukha was not interested in anything anymore. He was very tired and gradually started drinking alcohol. One day, when Mukha was on Manikarnika Ghat, a divine saint dressed in a white robe came there, and he moved on from there. The question arose in Mukha's mind, who is this brilliant person? So he started chasing that brilliant saint. The saint was walking forward and the Mukha was following him. The person went ahead and sat under the peepal tree. After sitting under the tree, the person called Mukha with his hand. The Mukha came forward and stood up. Then the person asked Mukha about him. Then Mukha explained his whole story to that great man. That sage listened attentively to the Mukha's story and said to Mukha, "I am not your master, but I will certainly help you. First of all, stop this burning of dead bodies. Stop drinking alcohol. Build a small hut under the shade of peepal tree near a rekti bridge. Just wear a kaupin. Beg for food. Do not kill animal to satisfy your hunger. Eat only once a day. Bath regularly. Chant Om after bathing. Do all this for 1 or 2 months. After 1 or 2 months, Mahatma Buddha himself will come to this place. He will have to cross the Varuna river to go to the Sarnath. Buddha will pass this way. He will rest for a while here in this hut. You wash his feet and give him water to drink. You will know that this is Mahatma Buddha by the look on his face. After drinking the water, he will depart for his pilgrimage to Sarnath, and for you will give a message. Listen carefully to that message and act accordingly." After saying this, the Mahatma left. After hearing all this, Mukha could not believe it at first. But Mukha believed the words of that great man and started preparing as he said. He followed each and every instruction given by the sage and completed each and everything. He also started meditating Om chanting every day as told by Mahatma. And finally the day came. One day while eagerly waiting for the moment described by the Mahatma, Mukha saw that it was very hot midday. A faded brown robe monk was coming towards the bank of river Varuna where Mukha had built his hut. Seeing all these scenes with his own eye, Mukha became very happy. He immediately approached that hut and saw Gautam Buddha standing in front of him. As Sri M has described Gautam Buddha in his book, Buddha was such a fair, but his face was tan with a beautiful feature due to walking in the sun. The radiance on his face would make anyone's eyes bow down in a reverence. He had curly hair and tied it on his head. Buddha had very little facial hair. Buddha used to travel barefoot. Now Buddha was standing in front of Mukha, aka Sri M, as told by that sage. Mukha prostrated at Buddha's feet. Buddha touches his shoulder and made Mukha stand up and said, "Enough, enough, stand up." Buddha looked into the eyes of Mukha and gave a smile. Seeing that smile, Mukha realized what compassion is. Mukha was overwhelmed by all these sins. And indeed, if we were in Mukha's place and such incident happened to us, we too would have been overwhelmed. Mukha said to Buddha, "I want to wash your feet. Also, if you are thirsty, I want you to drink the fresh water from my mud pot." Buddha nodded his head in the affirmative. And receiving the Buddha's permission, Mukha immediately seated the Buddha on a stone slab and washed his feet. After wiping those feet with the cloth he had, he requested the Buddha to come and sit in the hut he had built. Buddha also accepted the request and went with him to the hut. After entering the hut, Mukha gave the Buddha a drink of clean and fresh water kept in the mud pot, and Mukha said, "Hey almighty enlightened being, you honor my request by coming to my hut and drinking water from a man of a lower status like me and made my life worthwhile. O Buddha, seeing all this, I pass out. I am not at all tempted by this mortal world. Please shelter me in your presence. Let me be with you." Then Buddha said to him, "You are a blessed soul. You are now completely on the right path, but I am not your personal guru. He waits for you in Dronagiri mountain in the Himalayas." Then the Buddha makes a prophecy about him. The Buddha says, "There are many hidden realms in this world. Due to some karmic process, you have to be reborn in those many realms. After many births, you will be born near a Badrinath in the house of yogi family and you will become a disciple of your guru." Buddha further say, "Do one thing tomorrow. Cross Varuna river and come towards Sarnath. Tomorrow I am going to comment on something which is ultimate truth. So I want you to be part of that meeting and experiences that supreme power." Having said this, the Buddha then resumed his journey towards Sarnath. And as he walked, the Buddha gradually disappeared from the sight of Mukha. Mukha also immediately started his journey towards Sarnath. On reaching Sarnath, Mukha also attended the Mahasabha where Gautam Buddha was going to comment on the ultimate truth. And along with many disciples, Mukha also acquired the knowledge of the ultimate truth. Now you may think all this story is fictional and imaginary, but it's nothing like that. Because you will find this incident in Sri M's book, The Journey Continues. If you are interested in incarnation and spirituality, then you must read this whole book. You will get to read many more such incredible incidents like this. This incident is described in more detail in the book. And if you are really like this video, then share it with maximum people and share your valuable opinion with us in the comment box. Thank you.